My capsule wardrobe was both a success and a colossal failure. If you're thinking of trying it, I am sharing some of the valuable lessons I learned along the way, including the biggest mistake I made, the one little slip up I had, what I wore, and why I won't be doing it ever again. Let's go. Hi guys, it's Laura from How to Get Your Shit Together, and I help busy women get organized, get motivated, and get the most out of their wardrobe. Every year for the month of August, I take on a challenge. I force myself to focus on one thing for 1 month. August 2018 was the capsule wardrobe. Now, if you've been following me for a while, you probably know that I have a lot of clothes. In fact, you may be privy to the secret rule book that some people seem to have access to because they can tell me, apparently, that I have too many clothes. When it came time for me to decide how many I was going to limit myself to for this challenge, not having seen this book before, I just had to pluck a figure out of the air. I decided to stick to just 15 items of clothing, excluding underwear, outerwear, footwear, and accessories. Seemed like a reasonable amount, especially given that most kind of typical capsule wardrobes include 30 pieces, and people wear those all year round. My biggest mistake, though, was not making my outfits mix and match enough. I thought I had, but when I started wearing them, I quickly discovered that two of my trousers couldn't really be worn with anything other than the two plain white t-shirts I had included. So if you are going to try the capsule wardrobe, make sure that for every pair of trousers or bottoms you have several tops that will go with them. I did have one little slip up, I swear it wasn't intentional, I didn't even realize it until after I had done it. I had included one vest top just as a layering piece. It's in a nude color. I have several of them. I wear them all the time under t-shirts. When I went home to Ireland, I picked up two more, and without even thinking, I wore them as layering pieces. Honestly, it wasn't that big a deal. No one could even see them. But if this is something that you are going to try, separate out all of your extra clothes and or your new clothes as much as you can. Remove them completely so that you don't put them on kind of out of habit or just without thinking. I had separated mine, but like I said, I was home in Ireland, so I was basically living out of a suitcase for those 2 weeks, and all the new stuff just got thrown on top of all the old stuff. I also spent one entire day just in my pajamas, living my best life. Still, aside from that, I did stick with it, but I found it really tough, very limiting. I know for a lot of people it feels really freeing to have less choice, and that is usually true for me, but when it comes to clothes, I'm of the mentality that more is more. Not ideal for an aspiring minimalist like me, but I guess I don't have any skincare products or any cosmetics, bar eyeliner, so it probably all balances itself out. Okay, more advice or just things to watch out for if you are going to try it. Try and include something that is a little bit dressier, just in case you happen to go out for dinner or something. Bonus points if it can pull double or even triple duty. I picked out a black dress that could be jazzed up with a few snazzy accessories. It could be polished if I pulled on a blazer, or I could just wear it with flats for the other 99.9% of my life. I did have to do laundry a lot more frequently. Normally I can get away with just putting on a washload of clothes every 2 or 3 weeks or so and still be fine. I still wash bedclothes and towels every week, so calm down. But for this, I needed to be washing clothes at least once a week so that I wasn't wafting eau de sweat all the time. So that is something to be mindful of. I also attended a 2-day event during the month that I didn't know about when I first started the challenge, and I would have liked to have worn something a little bit, I don't know, just special for the occasion. But I wore two different snazzy jackets on those days, so I was still able to bring a bit of my personality to it. I definitely would have preferred to wear something else though. The lesson, try to have some fun items in there too. Everything I chose was very plain, and while that is much easier for mixing and matching, it just doesn't portray my personality. I mean, yes, I do wear all those clothes, they are great staples, they're very versatile, but often I like to wear things that are a little bit left of field, you know, a little bit quirky, or with a fun slogan or something. So take your personality into account, be conscious of the clothes that you normally wear. And like I said, you can do a lot with some carefully chosen accessories, you know, maybe a bright bag or a great jacket. So, where do I think it all went wrong for me? I think my biggest struggle was that I had a serious case of closet FOMO. All of my other clothes were still there, so I felt like I was missing out. I felt like I was depriving myself. Now, I am not a fashionista by any stretch of the imagination, but I do enjoy putting outfits together, and I enjoy having options when it comes to those outfits. And I have already done a huge cull of my closet, several in fact, over the last few years. So even though I have a lot, it is still way less than before, and it is all stuff that I truly love and that I have carefully selected. It's still Capsule, it's just a much bigger capsule than other people's. If you are like me, the true capsule wardrobe is probably not for you. I would still encourage you to whittle things down though, to hone your signature style. Mine right now can probably best be described as 90s children's TV presenter. But if you haven't decluttered your clothes, or if you find that you are just not very happy with what you have, then definitely try it. It will force you to focus on the pieces that are actually working for you. Either way, one of my biggest tips when it comes to your closet is to choose your outfits in advance. Every Sunday, I pick mine and Scout's outfits for the coming week, and it saves me untold time and heartache. If you have never tried it, give it a go this Sunday. Check your planner to see where you're supposed to be, and then check the weather forecast and plan your outfits accordingly. Hang them up and see how much quicker and easier your mornings are. I have a much greater appreciation for my clothes after this challenge, so it has been beneficial in that regard. It has confirmed that I like having lots of clothes. It's moved me closer to finding a true signature style for myself, which is actually one of my New Year's resolutions for this year, and it has made me so much more grateful for what I have. But I don't think I'll be doing it again. I don't know. Have you ever done it? What do you think? If you want to see how I did my most recent closet declutter and to see how many clothes I actually have, hop on over to this video. I really struggled through that one. Or check out previous year's challenges right here. And if you like those, subscribe. Until then, Karev Mila Magwev. Agus Pekimeshiv Shigalua. Slán.